Hey guys, so this weekend Bogdan and I were hanging out and we noticed that Elon Musk is actually selling flamethrowers now to raise money for the Boring Company. And upon further investigation, we realized we could probably build one with stuff that we have laying around the shop. So that's what we did.
Well, this is a reverse thread too. Confusing.
Okay. Wow. I'm impressed. How have I never played with this? I bought this a year ago. It was on sale for like $30. Do we want a better gun though? A bigger one? It does look a lot like that. Looks.
Just like pan the camera over, just like.
It looks a lot like this Nerf gun we got up here. Okay, hang on.
And look at the barrel.
Oh, it's a tank on top.
Yeah, that's literally just a propane tank. Like, oh, yeah. Oh, I don't know. Maybe this one right here?
Looks a lot like it.
Right there. So we got a Nerf gun. Duct tape that there. Duct tape this.
Duct tape.
Right there.
It's too easy. What went in the
batteries.
Front? All right.
Or in our case, an electronic igniter.
Yeah, let's do it.
How much did that thing cost you?
It's on sale. I'm pretty sure I only paid like $30 for it. Even normally, it's probably only 50. Propane.
This is quite tightly threaded in.
Doesn't want to do anything. All right, so we found enough fittings in our box of goodies here. Why is the flow backwards? But hang on. Does this have a flashback arrestor right now?
I don't think so, because propane doesn't flashback unless you get air. Here, the only time they actually can mix is after they exit the nozzle, which is why that nozzle is a smaller diameter.
That's hot.
It's hot.
Yeah! Alright, stop it. Sweet. Woohoo! There we go. Woo!
Hey, you probably should have touched it.
Who knew brass conducted heat so? Once the screwdriver handle starts melting, we know what we're at. All right, stop.
Let's just set it on the floor.
Yeah, we just have open the valve now. This is sweet. Oh my god. That'd be a cool feature too. Like rapid fire, it's like bam. All right, it's done. Time for the final piece. The Hacksmith and Company. All right, so it's Monday morning now, and Ian doesn't know that we actually built the flamethrower already, so I'm gonna go show him. Anyways, I knew you wouldn't be keen on the idea, so we already did it.
Nice.
So, to start, you have to turn the pressure on low. We should probably go downstairs. Over here.
I thought I recognized that valve in the Facebook.
All right, so just a little bit. Okay, so there's a solenoid valve. So, this is gas, and this is the trigger. Just hit the trigger. Too much. You really have to start like super low. Now crank it. I didn't even know I could do that. What the hell? All right, stop. We only have some fuel with the painted tank.
My face feels weird.
Pretty close to the original, huh? So this build only took us a few hours to do and probably cost around $50 plus a few parts that we had laying around the shop. Now, I know this wasn't a complete tutorial on how to make one, but it's really not that hard and it's really just some basic components from the hardware store. That being said, if you want to support Elon Musk and his crazy ventures, check out boringcompany.com/flamethrower if you want to just buy one that's already made. Wait a sec. They're sold out? Well, I guess you guys are gonna have to build your own. And if you guys haven't watched the video where we test this out, check it out because I go a little bit crazy.